At the recently opened Café Landwer in Boston, they serve breakfast whenever you crave it, morning, noon, or night. Located on Beacon Street at Audubon Circle, this is the first U.S. location for an Israeli chain with more than 70 locations back home.
The concept is to give the guests whatever they want all day, and breakfast is one of our specialties. If someone is coming at 10 a.m. or is coming at 10 p.m., he will get the same thing. Whatever the guests want, we want to fulfill it.
Israeli food typically comes with a side of healthfulness, hence the chopped salad with the farmer's breakfast on focaccia. The famous breakfast comes with two eggs, plus a slew of ramekins filled with everything from feta cheese to chickpeas to granola and honey. Already the shakshuka is wildly popular. There are three versions on the menu. This is the Mediterranean. Not familiar with shakshuka? It's a breakfast staple in Israel.
So in the dish we have the tomato sauce, and then there is eggplant and feta cheese, and of course the poached eggs. And we're serving it with side salad and with a ramekin of tahini.
The best way to eat it, they say, just dig in. You can use a fork, but I'm opting for the bread. Ta'im me'od, which is taste good in Hebrew. A heavenly cup of Java is what Landwer is proudest of. The company has a long history dating back to 1919, when the Landwer family first started roasting beans in Berlin. And that, my friends, is a smooth coffee. Café Landwer is kid-friendly, adding adorable snacks of fruits and veggies to breakfast. For the sweet tooth, the pancakes with Nutella and homemade whipped cream do the trick, as does this pastry delivered warm and gooey.
It's a pizza dough with a Nutella. You can't beat a fresh bread baked with a Nutella inside.
Now we're off to Wayland, where since 1958, Mel's Commonwealth Cafe has been riding a non-stop breakfast wave. Though in its early years, it was a donut shop started by the father of current owners, Paul and Stu Bloomstein.
One day a customer came in and said, hey Mel, what about putting some eggs on the menu? And my father said, well, I don't really know how to cook eggs. So this customer brought in a frying pan and a dozen eggs and showed my father how to make eggs. And before you knew it, breakfast was born.
60 years later, Mel's is now a neighborhood fixture along a low-key stretch of Comm Ave called Route 30. In boom times and recessions, they've been known for their ample, always piping hot griddle breakfasts. French toast made with cinnamon raisin bread, eggs Benedict serve on Portuguese English muffins, and golden brown waffles.
One of the most popular waffles is a three-footed waffle with bananas, strawberries, and blueberries with whipped cream. We also do one that's very popular. It's like an apple pie waffle with apple pie filling, and we put whipped cream and crumb topping on top of it.
It's the consistent quality of the food and the longevity of the staff that keeps bringing eager morning diners into Mel's.
50% of the staff has been here for 20 or more years, and I'd say there's six or seven of them that have been here 30 years or more.
I feel that we're a destination restaurant. People do come from all over. We know a lot of the regulars, and we know them by name, and we know what they eat, too.
It's certainly enticing that the moment you walk through Mel's door, the aroma of just brewed coffee greets you along with oversized muffins. On a chilly New England morning, this is a welcoming hideaway to stoke the furnace in your belly.
You come in and it's a relaxed place, and there's a sense of community.
Can't go wrong. I never finish my meal, so that's a good sign.
The food is fantastic. Yeah, and then I have to go work out afterward.
And the Bloomstein brothers say their father taught them the key to longevity in the diner business is to always be on the premises.
Right, because their father said, look, never forget that diners have choices. They don't necessarily have to stick with you, so it's good for you to be invested there on the premises. It seems to be working because they have a lot of diners at the counter, the regulars, as they call them, who've been coming for decades. So something's working well there, in addition to the food.
And you know what? I think breakfast now is officially my favorite meal. Okay. A bagel without schmear is like a day without sunshine.
Chewy, good, delicious bagels, and nice, delicious schmear to go along with it.